Hello friends, my name is The Real Emile and welcome to some Forza Motorsport 5, and everything has gone wrong today. My internet's been crap, so I can't upload the Forza 2 Let's Play that was supposed to go out, and it's very hot, which means it's not very fun to work. But anyway, today I figured we would do something a little bit different. I haven't played the Forza 5 career mode in ages upon ages, and I figured I would play some career mode. And I assumed the car that you guys would probably like to see, because I know quite a lot of you are F1 fans, is a Formula 1 car. We have one here. This is dressed up like the Force India 2015 car. It's not really a Force India 2015 car. It's actually just a... I believe the car's the 2013 Lotus F1 E21, something like that. So, yeah, there you go. Anyway, I figured we would race the F1 car around some tracks that really don't suit F1 cars. I did try recording this before. I did the Alps race, which ended up with us almost rolling an F1 car. And I figured we shall go to Long Beach, because if any place in this game does not suit an F1 car, it would be Long Beach. Yeah, I've finished the championship. I've done every single championship on this game. Finished them ages upon ages ago, and I did do the F1 cars. I did okay in these cars. They're not my sort of cars, the F1 cars, you know. These are sort of the ultimate hyper race cars, and me personally, I preferred sort of driving, yeah, excuse me, more mundane cars. Sort of your everyday sports cars and supercars and hot hatches and of the like. So I did okay. I did terrible on this race, but that's because this race just does not suit these sort of cars at all. Like, at all. I don't think there's any track in this game that these F1 cars don't suit more than this. Yeah, that made sense. Anyway, I'm thinking what I'd speak about today, actually, is sort of... Oh my god, okay. I believe crashes like that have actually happened in real life, but it's interesting to see it on Forza. I will also explain, Forza does an okay job. Okay, so the first time we went around there, we didn't break anything. This time, let's just slam on the brakes. Nope, he's going to slide in front of us anyway. We came off a lot worse than that. Anyway, Forza doesn't... well, the AI, I should say, aren't great in these cars, especially around a sort of tight track like this. It can get very argy-bargy, which, you know, obviously, real F1 cars don't really get argy-bargy, because otherwise they'll break absolutely everything, as I... but yeah, what I kind of wanted to speak about today is sort of how it's sort of working in Forza 6, and how what sort of F1 cars I would like to see, and also just my opinion on F1 in general. For those of you who don't know, I believe Forza 6 will have an F1 car. I'm pretty sure they confirmed... it's slamming doors, excellent. I'm pretty sure they confirmed a... I can't remember what year it was. I'm pretty sure it's either a 2014 or 2015 car. Now, me personally, I'm not a huge fan of the 2015 cars. I appreciate sort of as feats of engineering and technology and so on, you know. They're only 1.6 engines, yet they have about 600 horsepower, which is mental. But for me personally, you know, I much prefer sort of the engines that were in this, which is sort of more your... I believe these, I don't know if they still use them. I'm pretty sure at one point F1 cars used 3-litre V8s. I'm not sure if this one is a 3-litre V8. It could be. Slightly cut in the corner, but we're in the lead anyway. That's a very odd paint job for that car. I have no idea why it's on there. Oop, god, there we go, spinning. Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of the modern 2015 cars. I'm pretty sure. Although, I'm sorry, professional. But I'm just kind of curious. What cars are actually in the distance over there? What is the... generic looking SUV. I assume that's supposed to be a Vauxhall Astra. I mean, it doesn't look bad from trackside, obviously, but I think I spoke about this in a recent video I did. The fact that these games always look fantastic until you start looking at them very closely, and then they sort of fall apart a little bit. But yeah, anyway, I'm not a huge fan of the 2015 cars. So I assume, now this isn't set in stone obviously, I'm pretty certain this car, this 2013 car will probably reappear. That's the thing with Forza 6, you know, it should in theory bring every car from Forza 5, because, well, they're already modelled and that for you, so you may as well use them. I mean, it's not like, at least I'm pretty certain the graphics have not improved between Forza 5 and Forza 6, which is fine by me, because, quite frankly, this game is absolutely superb looking. Can we catch the leaders? I actually was doing really well, and then I had to stop the recording for reasons, so that was fun. But yeah, so I think, by the way, in case you're wondering, the car they've confirmed is another 2015 Lotus. The only F1 car in Forza 5, at least modern F1 car, is the 2013 E21 Lotus. There's a couple of classic F1 cars. There's James Hunt's McLaren, Niki Lauda's Ferrari. I believe there's some, even some older cars. You got some Lotuses and some Brabhams and stuff, which is really cool. But me personally, in Forza 6, I would like to see more than one modern F1 car. And if I was to be honest, I would like to see, I don't know, I'd like to see sort of one of the modern cars, so one of them that are running the 1.6 litres with the 600 horsepower. However, I would also like to see a sort of a classic E-ish F1 car. I'd like to see something like, I don't know, 2003 Michael Schumacher Ferrari or something like that. Or the F2007, I believe that's what they've got in Gran Turismo. I would just like to see more than one F1 car, and to be fair, you know, I don't know why they're doing this, but for some reason they've decided that in Forza 6, they've confirmed that every single car from the Formula E 2015 season will be in Forza 6, so you've got absolutely every car that's on that grid, which I'm not a huge fan of Formula E anyway, just because the cars don't excite me. It's not just because they're electric, it's the fact that they can do about 140 miles an hour, and they kind of just sound like angry washing machines. But also, I believe every Formula E car is actually a Renault. At least it is in this game. They've got a Formula E car. I believe it's when they first actually announced Formula E, they put Formula E cars in this game. There's a 2014 Renault Spark. I'm pretty sure that's what they use for Formula E. And it's like, that car isn't different. Well, as you know, in F1, I'm pretty certain, you know, they don't just buy their engines from one place. You know, you have slightly different bits between the cars, and I would really like to sort of see more than one F1 car. If there's 10 Formula E cars, you could at least give us two modern F1 cars. But I don't think, at least it might happen in DLC, I don't think it's going to happen for the actual game, because I think we're actually on the last week sort of run up, where they're going to announce the last car. Can we get into third? They take this corner really slowly. Can I sneak up the inside of a Ferrari? Yes, I can. I'm going to take gold. Hey, look, there's some more helicopters going around. There we go. Across the line, in third, so I got a gold medal finally for this race, because I didn't before. I only had a bronze. Yeah, I don't. Why those? But I mean, I don't know. Maybe, I don't know if this is true. I don't know if F1 2015 actually has, like, sort of exclusive rights to every sort of modern F1 car, and sort of Forza just has to write off a Lotus sort of... I don't know, maybe there's a loophole that they've got with Lotus or something. Yeah, like it, whatever. I'm not a huge fan of this Force India paint job. I much preferred the old one when it was like white, orange and green. I have no idea what's happening with Force India as well. People seem to really like Force India nowadays, which is sort of strange. Because I remember they was kind of, I remember when they first came in, they was actually like quite underdoggy. That sounded really strange. Indianapolis or Le Mans? Let's go to Le Mans, provided it's not like a three-lap bloody race. Because I won't be in the mood for that. Say something. I've completely forgot what I was going to say. Anyway, I don't know what's happening with Force India. People seem to like them. If you like Force India, then more power to you, but I don't know why they've got so popular. Don't get me wrong, I like Force India. I'm always a fan of an underdog. And, so I don't know what's happening with that. Look at how long this circuit is. Please don't be three laps. It'll probably be two laps. Good. Forza 5 is actually pretty good at keeping the races to the time where they sort of need to be. It doesn't make them ridiculously, ludicrously, overly long. But at the same time, it makes them long enough that you can actually sort of catch up to the field. Two laps, okay. I should have really tuned the gears, and then I could have sort of got a straight line speed advantage. But, whatever. To be fair, the one really cool thing I like about these F1 cars is actually the fact that they use driver-to designs in this game to sort of, decorate the cars. And it, picks designs made by sort of users. And so you can actually get, like, even though there's only one F1 car and it only comes with one livery, which I've actually got two of these things, so I might show you at the end. The reason I've got two, in case you're wondering, is because basically, when I first bought this game, I got gifted a ridiculous amount of credits through Forza Rewards. It looks like the same's happening in Forza 6 as well, because I've got 60 million credits to confirm. Also, I've finally caved in, and some idiot on a dirt bike likes to keep going past. I've caved. I finally bought my Forza 6 Ultimate Edition and pre-ordered it. I wanted a physical copy, but it doesn't look like there will be. Okay. I could probably take that a hell of a lot faster, but he's sort of in the way. So can we sort of go round, maybe? No. He's smacked into a wall. He's smacked into a wall. Everyone is going everywhere. See what I mean? Yeah. I mean, F1 drivers make mistakes, don't get me wrong, they're obviously not perfect, but some of the mistakes they make in this are a little bit strange. We are definitely going to get the run-up on him. 204 miles an hour, that's the top speed of an F1 car, apparently. Turned in on him. there's me saying, oh, well, F1 drivers don't do this, and then turn in on someone. It'd be a drive-through penalty. I'd endanger his life somehow. I was saying something. I actually can't remember. See, well, I mean, today's just going horribly wrong. Everything's breaking. Even my brain is just breaking. More bikes, yay. Because that's what people really want in their lives. That really irritates me, actually. The whole Forza should have bikes. No, it shouldn't. It really shouldn't ever have bikes. Do you want bikes, go play Ride. To be fair, I hate bikes, in case you're wondering. I just know. Can we take that flat out? Yes, we can. That's very scary, taking that corner at about 180. I wouldn't want to drive one of these things in real life. I reckon it's terrifying. I'd like to get the paycheck afterwards, but to actually drive one of these things, nah. I think I'll leave that to Hamilton. Yeah, I have no idea what the season standings are looking like at the moment either. Last race I saw, Hamilton won. So, I mean, I don't know if Hamilton is sort of winning everything like he did last season. Because he won at last Yas Marina. I saw the last ever race of the 2014 season. Yas Marina. I really like that track, Yas Marina. I can't race it in this, unfortunately, because I didn't get do terrible enough. But I do like Yas Marina circuit. Hence why, on the only Project Cars challenge on Forza 5, I took him to there. Anyway, we beat Xbox Ahoy, and Hattrick Swayze, interesting name, is our next rival, apparently. I would take these things online, but quite frankly, I'm terrible with them, and the people around me will be even worse. And that's kind of why I don't race online in Forza, just because everyone is just terrible. Well, not everyone, I say. You know, there's obviously people who are out there, and they're trying to race properly. You can't say that flat out. I'm rewinding a lot. I shouldn't be doing that. You know, there's a lot of people who say do drive well at online lobbies. However, my experience is not good. I've done about 5 online races in the entirety that I've had Forza. Not with friends, obviously. Just with randoms. One race I particularly remember because I was driving a car and there's this idiot in a Shelby Daytona, I think it was. And each and every corner on Horizon 2, he would literally just run himself straight into a wall, like, next to me. Because usually in online races, I don't go for sort of the fastest line, I go for the safest. Because I know what people are like. So if I see some sort of idiot approaching at 120 miles an hour in my rearview mirror, I'll usually just sort of brake a bit later and maybe put myself out wide a little bit. And then he can, you know, sort of kill himself and I can carry on. I do have to admit, the races I did on Forza 5 weren't half bad. I've done a little bit of Virus, that's pretty fun, unless people glitch with the Caterhams and the Minis. And I actually played some circuit races and they were pretty damn good. Problem I have is my internet is very, very dodgy. One minute it can be the best thing in the world, next minute it will just kill itself, so... Excuse me, that's why I don't really do online stuff. I think I've explained it before. But if it ever gets fixed, which I'm kind of hoping it does, it's just sort of, yeah. I would kind of hope to get some more sort of online-y stuff out and maybe try out some more of the online racing. Because I'm sure there's some fun moments to be had with it. You can't race the AI forever. I'll probably end up doing it in Forza 6, because in this game, I got this game way late. As in, like, when I got an Xbox One, it was the 7th of October, I believe. And I got Horizon 2 for it, and then about a week later, I borrowed this. I think I did all the championships in, like, just 1 month, because this is sort of all I played for a month, so I just did them all then. So, provided the same happens for Forza 6, I will probably need to sort of migrate to online lobbies or something to try and keep interest, if you will. Ooh, God. Rumble strips, not very nice. This is the point with the F1 car. This is probably the most terrifying car to drive in the game, at least in my opinion, just because it so warps you. Like, literally, you can drive nothing quick around the track, and nothing will snap on you quite as fast as an F1 car will. They're a little bit tricky to get used to. Can I get across the line before he gets there? Yes, I can. 325. Bear in mind, I believe Le Mans cars run about 4 minutes around there, so... That's interesting. I guess the F1 car wasn't too unsuited to Le Mans after all. There we go. We also get a hell of a lot of money because we raced at Le Mans. And hopefully we get a lot of XP so we can do level up and stuff, because leveling up is pretty cool. There we go, level 258. Yeah, I played this game a lot. Speaking of which, actually, I'm almost done with this. Like, I've literally got 2 more cars to buy, and both of them are Indy cars. Which I might actually buy, because I've got, like, 4 million credits. I believe Indy cars are 1.3 million. For one, so... I may buy the other two remaining cars. Anyway, I don't know. If there's any decent tracks, I will do a last sort of episode. I don't like Nürburgring. I don't particularly want to race these at Indianapolis. Or Le Mans thingy. So I think we will leave it there. Yeah. So I didn't crash as much as I thought I would, which is certainly something. And yeah, you guys got to sort of see some F1 cars. I hope F1 2015 has rewind, yeah. Because otherwise I don't think I'd do too well at that game. Yes, look at all the shiny stuff. But yeah, I want to thank you all very much for watching. My name's been The Real Emile, just so you know. Yeah, that's the standard colour scheme. 750 horsepower, 2.4 litre, okay. So is it a 2.4 V8? It might be. I love how it's like a Honda, it has no torque. Joking, I love Hondas. But anyway, I want to thank you all very much for watching. My name's been The Real Emile. Until next time, farewell.